Hello everyone, and welcome to the Blobber Plays EU4 with our with little help campaign in Mare Nostrum. Last time, we finished off the silly war that Florence pulled us into for a single province. We declared on, although it did free Ravenna, they did actually make Milan spit out Venice, which we have since gone to war for and absorbed. We're going to absorb Mantua. And then we're going to consider what our aggressive expansion is like and whether we want to continue by eating more of Milan, maybe Parma, depending on how things are going. Want to eat Parma, actually. Maybe we spend some time building a spy network. Actually, kind of more of a hard choice than usual. I think given how... No. I'm gonna say given how young he is, let's say we can do him two more times. If we do him two more times... I think this is better. We can afford to do him twice more before we start getting too big as a... too big of a merchant republic, and we start losing points that way. That's disastrous. He's a level 1 guy? Ooh, he passed some reforms. Yay, extra unrest reduction. Off, look again. Reichsregiment! Who are you allied with? Switzerland and Genoa. But it doesn't really matter who you're allied with because Austria owe me favours. Not yet. You owe me lots of favours, you ungrateful bastard. Ottomans eat emeriti. Happily may they be forced to spend increased coring cost. Better than them going and eating QQ or something. And also it could bring them into conflict with Russia. Their loves. Oh, Theodoro. Told you to vassalize them. As Russia loves Theodora, when eventually the Ottomans might try and go eat them. How are the Ottomans doing for attacking the Mamluks? Up. The Mamluks have gotten some useful allies, potentially. Although they won't get military access, probably. Chernigov exists? Ooh. Ooh, icky. Oh. This war nearly finishes. No, I will not risk the Pope discovering me. Speaking of whom, let's remind him that I don't hate him, but it was purest happenstance that called me in against him. Points for his... Eh, that's not that bad. While he's hating us. I'm gonna need to core stuff. I'm gonna need to let my war exhaustion come down first, so let's get that extra trade power and see how our trade goes up. It is 7.07. Point six, so an extra half a ducat. Let's say. That siege is over. Let's eat that. Ask for his money. Nothing else we can do because he ceases to exist. Speed down. Fabricate that other claim here. Peace with you will come to an end eventually. How's my aggressive expansion? I mean, I can't... doesn't matter about the Pope because he's got a peace with us. What we care about are these guys. If those guys would start caring, our ally, so it doesn't matter so much. I can go after Ferrara. Allied only with Siena. Low diplomatic reputation from integrating our vassal. Quite soon is precluding us. Is there a diplomat? There is. We fix that problem. Say Austria. Oh yes, he only does one these days, not two. Sometimes it's hard to remember this. Give it a sec. Let's also finish building that spy. Oh no, we've got enough. Fabricate a claim on him. Have a look who will Austria let us call him in against. Suppose I could just spend down five of our... there. They are in a trade league with Lübeck. Switzerland, and they are in a trade league with Genoa. But a lot of people, including Genoa, won't actually ally it, hold it. So who would it be? Would it be them? Switzerland, tiny, and won't get access if we don't, our allies, give it to them. Who again we can go crush after. For sure. Now if we're going to take all of this, having that single fort might actually be worth it. But we want to up here. Like to up there when we can. Extension that we will stop expanding for a bit. So we'll let say 50, 60, 70, 90. So if I went for Modena, it would actually take us up towards 100. No, I think this is the last one. Now we can miltech up, so we will. We can diplotech up, so we will. Hopefully this excellent leader lasts long enough to get us back up on time with that. Because we want to fight corruption by being ahead of time. Oh, Schmig, I shouldn't have taken that. I shouldn't have taken this until we had caught that one up. Okay, that's my bad. He doesn't have a real fort, which makes some of that a bit nicer. Build up the extra mercenary. Because we're about to consolidate down our normal troops. actually quite a lot less than I would have imagined. Mercenaries took too much of that damage. Well, how many do we need to leave here? We need to leave 3, I believe. That's what we do. Everyone else? We assess how much Switzerland have. Switzerland have 4. We should be able to beat that with 7. So we say, suddenly give us access again. Let me go beat up Switzerland. Oh, please, Cyprus, please declare your independence. Actually, I might support his independence. Meantime, if we're going to eat him, who else might get tired? Who might get fearful? Might get fearful. Although you might stop existing, that's also possible. They have a real fort. They also don't have a real fort. Consolidate down. Build. Mercs back up. We're losing money, but only very slowly. And then Oldenburg. Far out, that's gonna be unpleasant to. How many units do they have? Not much. Not that I have much. Three. So once this finishes, we also head up to Oldenburg. Oh, someone cancelled our access somewhere, so let's bring our diplomats back and fix that. So, you give me access. And you give me access. And we go crush them. Consolidate down, remove the one that's not sieging. Does he have a fort? No. You know what, but we leave one, because it's needed. And we ask them if they are willing to perhaps stop being an idiot. But of course not. Now what were we doing? We were improving with Genoa. And we were improving with Lucca under the assumption that they will exist, which doesn't seem safe anymore, so we could improve with the Pope instead. And speed up. There we go, so he does stop existing. Out with Genoa. We want to leave a diplomat free so that we can ask them if they're changing their minds about staying in the war. Diplo. Oh, oh. We care about the Diplo more because we want to tech up to help fight corruption. Please say that that was... Yes, it was. Excellent. This should prevent the... help minimize the amount of land the Ottomans take. Because instead, Cyprus will take it. Now we'll speed down so that we can make sure to catch this siege when it finishes. And, oh, pop an extra person on there. In fact, we'll make it. Oh. Did you cancel my access? I have military access. Did you? There. Now what we can do is cancel these other ones that we don't need. Need this one. Kind of? Nah, let's just have them hop on there and then we'll cancel that one too. Speaking of which. Boom. Boom. Whoop. We ask them if they wouldn't maybe like peace because they were fools. They say yes. We get to bring our troops home. They might even arrive home in time for Christmas. Yes! Speed up. We would care about these guys. So we'll improve with these guys. Now, get all of the non-mercenaries. No, get half of the non-mercenaries off. And unfortunately, we have to reinforce there. No, no, we don't anymore. Let's just put one there so that even when we get a disease tick, it doesn't stop. Happening in the rest of the world. Well, Muscovy are doing a good job of expanding down to Circassia, who they might try and ally, which will be good because it will bring them into conflict with the Ottomans. Albania is going to try and eat Chernigov, I imagine. Having another go at Crimea until you take religious. Or hit tech 10, you're not going to be able to convert the Sunni lands, I'm sorry. We're going to keep him again. But no, we must do this so that we lose the corruption from unstable tech. And then we want to get this and then start a military idea set, quite possibly plutocratic. Because we're probably going to need the plutocratic policy that gives you bonus republican tradition in order to stay a republic once we get too big. Now you are fools. Stop having stupid allies. Austria, help pretty please. Yes! No. No, Austria, you came to help the wrong one. No! Austria! No! Oh, you're not going to help me? But, well, that's new. In the old days, your allies would almost certainly help you like this, in a situation like this. Still, it gives us more of an excuse to do what I've been wanting to do, more and more of these. Go full occupy there. Yep, they're gonna try and come this way. Leader, we'll take this piece. Tough luck. That's no good. Oi. Help me. You know what? There's no more Venetian aside from Venice, which they can't get to, so hopefully they go there for Venetian instead, and then Austria will take care of them. So you could have avoided this if you just helped me in the first place, Austria. Just saying. Okay. Now we sit and we wait for our war exhaustion to come down. Take about 6 years, then we core. Opt to core. We consider the next phase of our expansion. Probably nothing, because we've got too much aggressive expansion again. Do is turn this zone. Armor is not a core, I'm not allowed to do it yet. Fine. Now he won't join. We can still improve there. We can go improve with Poland to make sure he stays our ally. I just have to wait. There's too much war exhaustion. Too much. I could become Defender of the Faith, but that would just convert our money even more so into nothing. Now, these guys go back to protecting, well actually, let's do what we did before. So that half hunt pirates in Venice, half hunt pirates in Ragusa, and then the rest trade in Venice. Help our income go up, so trade is 8.4 at the moment. 9, so that does help. Guys still haven't gone for their independence because they're a fool. Isn't max. Try and go release Byzantium. And I quite like that as an idea. I could use a Byzantine vassal. I have to be sure. Spies. I wouldn't be doing much in that war, it would all be Austria and Poland. base tax. Could even claim one more province. Increases at a lovely rate. Act. Might be an idea to click the button. That one's not worth clicking, because they're already below 25, so. Venice, however. If we're accepting that we put the rebellions down with mercenaries. No, I still need this. I might have to go improve with Austria again soon, but. Who are our rivals? Milan, Ferrara, Siena. I could declare some wars just for the sake of power projection, but that doesn't feel worth it. Yeah. Suppress it even more. You know what? It might be even worth trying to get 100 here so that we can keep killing their king before they can declare war. Try and trigger the new regicide event. If you have 100. If you have 100 spy network against someone, you can actually get a chance at assassinating their king. As an event. Have a look. Florence wants to eat. Vienna. My rival. So of course I accept. I don't like that it's interrupting my war exhaustion. Like, seriously, stop declaring wars. At least this time you're not so stupid. Once more. 666. Oh. Probably gonna die by the end of this turn. So we go. That one. That one. So that I can go make a Byzantine vassal one day. Yeah, gain corruption. Not losing stability, because stability. One of its traits is it gets rid of corruption, so why would you ever pick the other one? Unless, I suppose, you could be in a condition where you had really, really high corruption already and didn't care much about the extra little bit of corruption. But most of the time, I imagine you're going to be, like, at low corruption. Now I need a new enemy. Could pick the Papal State. Some pretty strange allies. States look like here. I could only really get those two. I don't want to have Rome. Rome's just a target for all the Catholic. I do still want that though. I would like all of these. How many provinces am I at? So I can get four more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's also build up a network against Hungary. Can I back up? Oh. Oh yeah, I was trying to decide. So. Genoa. No, because then these idiots will call me in against Genoa, which calls me in against Hungary. So I pick Provence. Aragon. I hate Aragon, and they're gonna get eaten. And if I go eat Sicily at some stage, then that would be brilliant too. No. Willing to have. Hate me, but I could fix that. Maybe if I support them as well, they'll go declare. Is the idea. But in any case, I have to do that next time. It's time to draw this episode to a close. It has been the Blobber with our with a little help achievement in EU4, Mare Nostrum. I hope you've enjoyed watching, and will join us again soon. Bye bye.